Hey, I know you.
No, you don't.
That's one heck of a Sunday.
Looking for someone?
Goddamn Bruins are having a season.
LAPD, we're looking for any known associates of Adrian Black.
Adrian? He's your most nice with Frank Morgan. They camp out the table in the back and talk on a closing. Frank's back there now.
Ooh, could I get a bowl of that chili?
Frank Morgan?
Who's asking?
Cole Phelps, LAPD. I understand you're a friend of Adrian Black.
Yeah, I know.
Are you aware that he's missing?
No, I hadn't heard that. Tough break.
We found Black's car abandoned in a freight depot, covered in blood. You know anything about that, Morgan?
Hell no. I'm sorry to hear that. I like Adrian. He's a good boss.
Please, don't tell me you actually believe this jerk-off, Phelps.
I think you were in on it, Morgan. You drove down there, and you let Black have it.
Ooh, I'm a bad boy. Is that the best you got?
When did you last see Adrian?
Hell, I don't know. I had plenty to drink last night. Things are a little sketchy.
You're lying, Morgan. What happened to Adrian?
I have 10 guys who say I was here the whole night. You think you can prove I was there?
Sorry. Sometimes you have to shake the tree to see what falls out.
Come on, Morgan. It was only last night. You must remember something.
Look, we might have had a drink. We have a drink most nights after work.
This doesn't add up, Morgan. Your excuses don't help. Let's see how you enjoy the LAPD taking an interest in your life.
You want my opinion? Lieutenant Morgan, I say he's lying, and whatever hole he's got Adrian stashed in, he's got to go back there sometime.
Sure left his drink in a hurry. I bet he wishes he'd rehearsed that story better now.
I'm out of here.
That's too close, Phelps. Way too close. Be a bad time to forget how to drive, Cole. Easy, Cole. Better back it off.
Where are you taking us, Mr. Morgan?
Let's check the place out.
Day one of the big time, and you're already tailing drunks home from bars. You having fun yet? I told you it was non-stop glamour work in traffic, didn't I?
I'm just trying to learn.
Oh, come on, Phelps. Save the creepy teacher's pet stuff for Leary. Won't work on me.
Apartment 2.
All right, let's pay our friend a visit, see if he's missed us yet.
Or anytime, let us be able to...
Who the hell is that? Will you relax? Jesus, Adrian, I told you, we're in the clear. I'll get it. Ah, shit.
It's over, Morgan. Mr. Black, LAPD, give yourself up now.
I knew it!
Phelps, go after him. I'll try and hit him off in the car. Gunner's the last resort.
There's no point running, Adrian. Mr. Black, get back here right now. It's over, Adrian.
Stop right there, Adrian.
Why did you need to get out of L.A. so fast, Adrian? Why the melodrama?
I've met somebody in Seattle. She means everything to me. We were going to start a new life together.
Looks like she'll have to wait for you. Adrian Black, you're under arrest for conspiracy and fraud. We'll see what the D.A. has to say about wasting police resources on a wild goose chase like this.
You're going to the big house, Adrian. And when your wife finds out, you're gonna lose her too. I hope this broad was worth it.
That turned out to be quite some case, huh?
Adrian, what an idiot. You got an arrest and a clearance in your first case, and in fine style, too. Well done, detective. Efficient investigation technique, good public presence. You keep that up and you learn from Bukowski here, you could go a long way in this department.
You have any plans for weekend liberty, Jack?
My sisters have been working in Los Angeles in a bomber factory. They're coming down to visit. I'm meeting them at the station at 6.
Good for you, Jack. Are they cute?
They're my sisters, Hank.
Attention! Final inspection before liberty.
Good job, Kelso.
Are we going somewhere, gentlemen? Full inspection. It had better be exceptional if any of you want liberty this weekend. Kelso, this carbine. The bore is dirty.
No, it isn't.
Are you arguing with me, Kelso?
Do what you need to do, Sergeant. You know the bore is immaculate.
Weekend liberty canceled. Two-day field drill. Clean this rifle.
No.
Do you know the penalty for insubordination, Kelso?
Jack, don't do it.
Forget him, Hank. He doesn't have what it takes.
Are you two finished? Are you going to clean this rifle?
No, Sergeant. Cole is right. I'm going to stop playing games and join a rifle company and fight the real enemy.
Gentlemen, I just got this handed to me. A hit-and-run felony at Ray's Cafe, 208 North Los Angeles. Got a patrolman on site. The coroner's on his way. Get down there, see if you can find any witnesses who can put a make on the car.
Mouthpiece for the script on the grand jury. Case got thrown out. Now the DA wants my head.
I want to make homicide. You know you're late.
Guy gave his wife a cat. I said, oh, yeah.
They weren't even his prints, and he still confessed.
I don't want to be rude, but I ain't got time.
You're behind the wheel.
Looks like the DA is going to press charges. Anna Rodriguez might do time.
I'll speak to the DA. She suffered enough.
I don't know, Cole. She's an easy make, and the DA likes convictions.
I'll convince him to let it go.
How do you do that?
I'll give him something better.
Detectives, over here.
Cole Phelps, traffic. What have we got?
Dick is a white male, named Lester Patterson. Walked out of the bar and into the street. Car hit over there, and he ended up here. Dead on impact by the look of it.
Have you canvassed the area?
The only one with anything useful to contribute is the young lady over there. She lives above the bar, named Shannon Perry. No, it's not a stage name. 24 years old, she left Kansas to follow the yellow brick road.
Is that so?
We'll take a formal statement later. Right now, we're going to take a look around.
Phelps?
Landed on his face and ended up here. Car must have struck him from behind. Notify next of kin. has as life insurance.
What have you got on the victim?
From all reports, he was intoxicated at the time of the accident. I don't know how intoxicated once I've done the autopsy. Looking him over now, I'd say he died on impact.
What about the chest wound? Isn't that inconsistent?
Very common in auto injuries. Look for a car with a prominent hood ornament. Those things are killers.
He traveled a good 20 feet.
This blood is a long way from the body. The car must have been going like a bat out of hell.
What do you say, Marley?
The driver managed to brake before the impact.
It's all yours, Detective.
Miss Perry?
Yes?
I'm Detective Phelps. This is my partner, Detective Bukowski. Can you tell us what happened?
Well, I came to the window because I heard people arguing downstairs.
Then what happened?
I saw a car hit that poor man and knock him down the street.
Tell me more about the argument you heard.
Well, there were two voices. A man and a woman, that's all.
Why are you holding out on us, Miss Perry?
I'm sorry. I was hoping to tell my story to the newspapers. I'd like to get my picture in the paper. I'm trying to find work as an actress, and things are pretty difficult.
Cough it up, sister. We don't have all night.
People arguing? They were husband and wife. I could tell by what she was yelling. Intimate things. Very embarrassing for the man.
What kind of car was it?
A dark red Lincoln Continental.
Why are you lying to me, Miss Perry?
You've got rocks in your head. Why would I lie about the car?
You don't ask, you never find out.
Did you see the license plate?
Only the first three letters, I'm afraid. 3C8.
Thank you, Miss Perry. Your information has been very helpful. You can go now.
You really think so? I hope you find that driver and put him away.
You certainly got away with the dames, Phelps.
Give it a rest, Bukowski.
Let's see what the patrons have to say.
I'll take the bartender. You work the rest of the room.
Thank you.
Courtney, come in. Have a seat.
Thanks, Doctor.
How are you finding working at the clinic?
It's, fine.
Are you sure?
Can I be honest with you, Doctor?
I would hope so, Courtney.
I was hoping that the therapy would be more beneficial.
Treatment can, unfortunately, be very long-term.
So many of the patients here are addicts, Doctor.
Many of them have been for years, Courtney. In the past, these people were condemned to sanatoriums. If we can reveal the root of the problem, then we have a chance to help them.
And until then, they stay sedated?
Do I detect a hint of reproach, Courtney?
I was expecting more, Doctor. I'm sorry. I don't mean to criticize.
Part of being a physician, Courtney, is learning to be patient.
How is it possible to keep so many of them on their medications, Doctor? Many of their addictions are illegal.
Oh, many things in life are gray, Courtney. What may on the surface appear to be illegal is actually of benefit to society at large.
I'm Detective Phelps of the LAPD.
How can I help, Detective?
Your name would be a good start.
Dudley Lynch. Hired help. I run the place when the owner ain't around.
Where is the owner?
He stepped out. Somebody had to take Lorna, Mrs. Patterson, home.
A witness overheard an argument.
Lester and Lorna. There's nothing like airing your dirty laundry in public, is there?
What was it about?
Who knows? The slightest thing could set those two off.
What can you tell me about the accident?
Not a lot. It was busy in here, and all I heard was the impact.
So you didn't see what happened?
By the time I got out there, it was all over.
Do you know the victim?
Yeah. Lester Patterson. He's a regular here, or he was.
Not one of your favorite customers?
Lester was special, but not my kind of special.
Was Lester drinking alone?
No. He came here with his wife. She didn't seem too interested in the booze, though.
Stalling just makes us more inquisitive, Lynch. We'll get to the bottom of this, with or without you. That guy has a serious attitude problem. Get anything out of the regulars?
They weren't giving too much away. They liked watching Lester and Lorna go a few rounds every other day. And Lester was a fan of the love tap.
Operator, message for KGPL.
Putting you through now.
Phelps, 1247. I need to run a partial license plate, 3 Charles 8. Cross-check possible Lincoln owners. Suspect vehicle is a red Lincoln Continental.
Just a moment, Detective. Only one possible make on that license. Registered to a William Shelton, 738 West Temple Street.
Thanks for your help.
Looks like we caught a break on this one.
Can you drive to this one?
Do we know where we're going?
it's right there. William Shelton?
Yes?
It doesn't look good, Shelton. You packing your bags and making a run for it? You know why we're here.
Yes. The accident.
We've got witnesses who can put this car at the scene, not to mention the physical damage. This is open and shut, Shelton.
That coward thinks he can run from everything.
Enough games, Phelps. Take this guy out. Lay into his wheel arches. Come on.
No wonder he killed someone driving like this. Don't let that asshole get away.
That's it. Cuff
Put your hands
done.
Where I can see them.
That was a vehicular manslaughter rap sound, Shelton. I hit him. I admit it. I just panicked, but it wasn't my fault.
What do you mean?
The guy jumped right out in front of me. He came out of nowhere. There's nothing I could do about it.
Why didn't you stop?
I've had accidents before.
That's it. We're done here. The DA is gonna love you.
They weren't all my fault. I'm a surveyor. I need my license for my job. There were people around. A woman and a man were standing right next to him. I thought they could get him to a hospital. I'm telling you, it's not my fault.
The guy is dead, Shelton.
You can't be serious.
William Shelton, you're coming downtown. We need to talk about a manslaughter charge.
Leave the coroner and the paperwork. Procedure can wait. We should probably go speak to the wife and let her know what's happening.
Okay. You become all hard at the prospect of paperwork, don't you?
So the wife was there when it happened, but then left the scene.
You're right. That's pretty unusual behavior.
She could be in shock. Tell some people strange things more after their buddies down there.
Maybe. Maybe she doesn't give a fuck. According to the patrons, her old man was a piece of work.
You don't think,
Phelps, the guy was run over. So it worked out well for this brush. So what? Maybe she deserved to catch a break. I don't know.
Yes? Hello?
Mrs. Patterson.
Is this about my husband?
We're investigating the incident, ma'am.
I see. Come in, won't you?
We wanted to give you the facts about the accident, ma'am.
I appreciate that, but I think I know most of them already, Detective. He was hit by a car, now he's dead. What more is there to tell?
Pardon me, but you don't appear to be too upset about it.
Lester and I met on a furlough in 44. We got married that weekend. People don't understand it now, but that happened a lot back then.
I see. So you probably did well to stick together this long.
What's that supposed to mean, mister? I think it's about time you left. I have someone here, and
I... Beg your pardon?
You're gonna have to run that one by us again, sister.
It's okay, Lorna. I'm Leroy Sabo.
Well, well.
Nice to see you're comforting the grieving widow, Mr. Sabo.
All right, wise guy. Do you have any intelligent questions you would like me to answer?
You can confirm Mrs. Patterson's story.
Lester lost at cards. He was kind of hard to control when he lost his temper. He turned without looking and walked right out in front of the car. It wasn't good.
What's your relationship with Mrs. Patterson, Mr. Sabo?
We're friends. Good friends.
You expect me to believe that?
Look, I was filing for divorce. Mental cruelty. Lester could be a mean son of a bitch.
And Lester knew about that?
No. I hadn't told him.
Well, hasn't this worked out well for the two of you? I feel almost bad for busting in on this little rendezvous.
You were arguing in the bar and on the sidewalk?
We were always arguing. So what?
Admit it. You were baiting him, pushing his buttons. We can easily get the full story from the regulars in the bar.
All right. Lester was playing cards out back. He lost, of course, and wanted back in. He suggested I earn the money on my back to get a mistake. That was the proposition he was putting to his so-called buddies. So maybe I was a little angrier than usual. Let's just say I took exception to his idea.
How did the car come to hit Lester?
He walked straight into the path of an oncoming car.
You're lying, Lorna. You pushed him in front of the car.
If you think you can prove that, I suggest you arrest me now. I would have loved to push him under a car many a time, but not this time.
We're leaving, Lorna, but this doesn't add up. We'll be keeping an eye on you.
Come on, Phelps. Let's make ourselves scarce.
I'm out of here, Lorna. I got a business to run.
Operator, give me dispatch.
Putting you through now.
Phelps, badge 1247.
How could I help, Detective?
Any messages?
Just one, Detective, from the coroner. Message reads, Phelps, see me at Central Morgue immediately. Results of the Patterson autopsy.
Thanks, ma'am. You know the way. You can drive.
And where exactly are we going?